So let's begin our today's section with section 9.4, reverse charge mechanism. Now please understand, friend, in last lecture also we have discussed reverse charge mechanism, but that reverse charge mechanism was given under section 9.3. Section 9.3 talks about notified services or goods will fall under reverse charge mechanism, whereas section 9.4 is talking about any supply. When originally this section was introduced, please understand, this is also of RCM, okay? Any unregistered supplier, please understand, any unregistered supplier giving services to a registered supplier, if this happens, then there will be a reverse charge mechanism on this registered supplier. It is too early for you guys to understand what kind of disaster it is and why industry has opposed this section strongly. Let me tell you a few facts of industry. What happens usually, it happens in income tax. People who know income tax provision, they might be knowing this. Usually, if assessee is having income of, say for example, 100 lakh rupees, okay? And he is having expenses worth rupees 70 lakh. He is having expenses, income worth rupees 100 lakh and expenses to the extent of 70 lakh. So, the profit is approximately 30 lakh. Now on 30 lakh rupees profit, he is supposed to pay tax, which I am telling you is too high under industry's understanding. He is like saying, no, I am not going to pay tax on 30 lakh rupees. I wanted to pay tax only on 5 lakh rupees. You can't show my profit of 30 lakh rupees, show my profit of only 5 lakh. This is what he said. Okay, this happens practically, I am telling you. So what will you do with 25 lakh? So for 25 lakh, we book bogus expenses, fake expenses. Okay. By recording fake expenses, we try to reduce the income tax liability. This usually happens, please understand, this usually happens in income tax. Now you please tell me, this 25 lakh rupees bogus expenses that you people are going to show, commission paid, advertisement expenses, okay, some professional fees paid, this will be paid to registered dealer or unregistered dealer, this 25 lakh rupees, which is a fake expense. These are the fake expense, unreal, okay? These are the bogus expenses. Will you show it to the unregistered dealer or registered dealer? Do you think you will pay to somebody genuinely? Hello? Are you going to pay it genuinely? What do you think? These are the unreal expenses. So you are not going to make payment of these expenses. You are going to just show entry. And obviously our service provider in these cases will be unregistered dealer. So to capture this type of situation, what GST department has done in this, GST department said whenever services are provided by unregistered dealer to register, whenever any supply is made by unregistered dealer to registered dealer, a registered dealer has to pay tax under RCM, reverse charge mechanism. So the burden of unregistered dealer is gone. Why unregistered dealer is gone? Because he's not registered, so he's not taking any GST burden. But look at me, I'm a chartered accountant and I'm a registered person. I'm a chartered accountant and I'm a registered person. I purchase certain stationery item from one stationery shop. Now I am responsible to pay tax on those stationery item because the stationery shop is an unregistered dealer. Secondly, I took a renting services from some particular assessee. Okay, so my landlord is not registered under GST law. So he has given me his premises to be used as the office premises. So he is not registered. Okay, so whatever rent I am paying, I have to pay tax on reverse charge mechanism. Whatever advertisement I am doing for my organization, on advertisement, that advertisement agency is unregistered, so I have to pay tax on reverse charge mechanism. So this was a little bit difficult for any registered person. See, this guy is already fed up with his own GST compliances and now he is expected to keep records of all inputs that he is taking from unregistered dealer, and this section was quite unreasonable at the beginning. Therefore, government amended this particular section last year. And right now, 9.4 is not applicable to all services or goods. No. Earlier it was applicable to all services and goods. Now it is applicable only to specified services or goods. Only to specified supply. So earlier it was applicable to all supply. Now it is applicable to specified supply. Let's look at the language of section 9.4. Okay. As per section 9.4, this is also reverse charge mechanism. Okay. The government on a recommendation of council by notification, what will they do? Specified as a class of registered person, specified class of registered person who shall, in respect of supply of specified categories of goods or services or both. So these two words are inserted now, specified. Okay. Received from unregistered supplier, pay tax on reverse charge basis. Now please understand what it is here. An unregistered supplier is supplying specified goods and services or both to specified registered supplier. Then a registered supplier is liable to pay tax under reverse charge basis for unregistered supplier. As of now, only one notification is issued, which is there in your syllabus. That is notification number 7/2019 CTR dated 29 March 2019. And this is applicable to real estate industry, construction industry. Okay, this is applicable to real estate industry, and here you should develop overall understanding of real estate industry. Believe me, friend, when real estate came in this world, okay, when GST was applicable on real estate, it was very difficult time for them. First of all, you should understand real estate in the industry where they park black money. A very good amount of black money circulates under real estate industry. So government wanted this. Modi government, they wanted to seriously, you know, tighten certain norms of the real estate industry so that a tax evasion will be reduced to maximum extent. So to put a lot of regulation on real estate industry, what all government have done? In 2016, at the beginning of 2016, they brought RERA. RERA means Real Estate Regulation Act. Okay, for Maharashtra, it is Maharashtra RERA. For Kerala, it might be Kerala RERA. So every state government is having their own Real Estate Regulation Act. So this Real Estate Regulation Act put a lot of control on builder. How can he use fund? How can he not use the fund? Lot of controls are already there in RERA. Then in 2016, 8th November, okay, what has happened? Demonetization has happened. When demonetization has happened, majority cash were taken from the market, and you know that in real estate, for these builders, cash is like a blood for them. Without cash, they cannot run their business, and demonetization hit this particular industry badly. Somehow they were trying to struggle and trying to stand. By 2017 in July, they launched GST on real estate. And when they launched GST on real estate, it was launched at the rate of 12%. Do you understand this 12% means how difficult it is? Please tell me, if you are going to buy a flat, okay, worth rupees 200 lakh, which is very nominal amount for people in Mumbai, you know that 2 crore rupees is nothing for buying a house in Mumbai. 2 crore is a minimum price. Okay, so on 200 lakh multiplied by 12%, the GST amount itself will be 24 lakh. Don't you think by looking at GST amount, many people, like if you wanted to buy a house, then you have to pay 200 lakh plus 24 lakh GST is equal to 224 lakh. By looking at a GST amount, many buyers have changed their decision of not buying property because property suddenly became unaffordable. These were a regulation that particular real estate industry was suffering, and it was almost about to die. So government had to provide some kind of relaxation to real estate industry. So government gave choice to real estate industry to pay tax at a concessional rate of 5% or 1%. Please understand. To pay tax at concessional rate of 5% or 1%. All these things I'm telling you just for your knowledge. You must understand this. Government have given now two rates to real estate industry. This is for metro cities or, you know, cities where real estate values are very high. And this is for non-metro cities Okay, and then there are certain conditions that you need to comply. One of the condition is this: ITC is not available. Whenever you go for this particular concessional rate 5% and 1%, ITC is not applicable. Input tax credit is not applicable to a real estate dealer. And apart from that, one more important condition which is there that you need to understand section 9.4, okay, which is whenever a builder is constructing material, sorry, is purchasing material for construction, okay, this material he must purchase from registered dealer at least to the extent of 80%. Given a choice, government would have said it as a government could have taken it to 100%, but in real estate, sand, water, many stones, many inputs they take from unregistered dealer, because this industry is unorganized industry. Therefore, they are saying, okay, not 100%, but at least 80% you must purchase from a registered supplier. So steel, chemical, paint, tiles, all these items you should purchase from registered dealer, so that minimum 80% should be achieved. Secondly, cement you have to purchase from registered only 100%. Cement is such a important product for government of India so far as revenue is concerned. So cement must be purchased from registered dealer if you wanted to avail 5% or 1% concessional rate on your output. So this is the offer we have given to the builder. Builder is known as a promoter in GST law. We call promoter to the builder. Okay, the promoter must purchase minimum 80% of inputs. So if to construct a project of 1000 crore, please understand, to construct a project, he has to take a raw material and inputs of 1000 crore. Minimum 800 crore has to be from registered dealer so far as other material is concerned. And if cement is required to the extent of 100 crore, apart from this, cement is required for 100 crore, then all 100 crore inputs has to be from registered dealer. Even if 1 crore cement is purchased from unregistered dealer, on that 1 crore, the promoter is liable to pay tax under reverse charge mechanism. And here, if he is purchasing 750 crore raw material from registered dealer, then the gap is 50 crore. On this gap of 50 crore, there is a RCM. Let me show you content from the module, what is written there. Look at the real estate industry. The effective rate of GST on real estate sector for new projects by promoter are as follows. So this is a real estate sector. 1% without ITC on construction of affordable houses, okay, on a construction of affordable houses. So right now GST rate is 1%, which is very much nominal rate. If you are buying a flat of rupees, say for example 45 lakh, yet the maximum value of flat is 45 lakh. So if you are buying a flat of rupees 45 lakh, you just have to pay GST of 45,000, which is very much nominal as compared to earlier 12%. A 12% of 45 lakh comes to 5.4 lakh. So please understand what is the difference. Earlier, assessee was liable to pay 5.4 lakh rupees GST. Now, assessee is paying only 45,000 GST. That's the difference this particular rate has created. And therefore, you must understand what are the conditions. The condition to avail this 1% rate are major condition. First of all, you are not liable to take ITC. Second condition, the area of your house should be maximum 60 square meter, okay, for metro cities, and 90 square meter for non-metro cities. See, metro cities houses are valued very high, and therefore they are talking about very small house. 60 square meter means approximately 600 square feet, which means they are talking about maximum 1 BHK. Okay, so 60 square meter in metro city and 90 square meter in non-metro city, and the value of house should not exceed 45 lakh. Then that house is qualified as affordable house, and if your house is affordable house, you as a builder, you are liable to pay tax only at 1%. Sir, what if I don't comply with this condition? Then okay, you have to pay tax at the rate of 5%. But please understand, your commercial area should not exceed 15%. What do you mean by 15%? So if you are constructing building of 10,000 square feet, okay, if you are constructing building of 10,000 square feet, so maximum 1,500 square feet you can reserve for a shop, not more than that. So commercial area, so these rates are specifically for residential complex. These are not for commercial complex. This is what you need to understand. Okay. So what are the other conditions? That condition is very important. ITC should not be available. And the second condition that I was telling you, minimum 80% of input and input service. Minimum input, 80% of input and input service other than land. Oh, other than land, that we will discuss later on, because land is exempt other than land. Okay. Electricity, high speed diesel and motor spirit, anyhow it is not under GST, so it is other than this. Use for supplying the service shall be purchased from a registered person. Now, if you do not purchase this 80% from a registered person, say for example, you had purchased only 65% from a registered person and balance 35% you have purchased from unregistered person. So maximum input you must have taken from registered person over the 20%, because 80% is required. Minimum 80% from registered person is required. So the gap to make it 80%, you need to add 15%. On this 15%, the material that you have purchased from unregistered person, okay, you have to pay GST on reverse charge mechanism. Look at this language. However, if the value of input and input service purchased from registered supplier is less than 80%, the promoter means builder, has to pay GST on reverse charge basis under section 9.4 of CGST Act, okay, at the rate of 18% on all such inward supply, to the extent it's short of 80%. So you don't have to pay on 35%, you just have to pay whatever is short. So if you purchase 78% from the registered supplier, so the short amount is only 2%, on that you have to pay GST, okay, on reverse charge basis. Further, for cement the law is different. This you should remember for multiple choice question. Further, for cement received from unregistered person, the promoter shall pay tax on reverse charge basis, okay, under 9.4 of CGST Act at applicable rate. And the applicable rate as of now for cement is very high, which is 28%. So you can understand there is no concession here in cement. If you purchase, what law is suggesting, 100% cement must be from registered. 100% cement from registered. If you purchase any cement bag from unregistered person, then you have to pay tax at the rate of 28% on RCM basis. Moreover, capital goods shall be paid by the promoter on reverse charge basis under 9.4. And if you are purchasing any capital goods from an unregistered supplier, on that also you are supposed to pay tax. So this is what you should understand so far as the real estate industry is concerned. Now please understand, CA intermediate, for that what they have written, or for intermediate examination what they have written, the discussion of above para highlighted in green is solely for the purpose of knowledge and not meant for examination purpose. So they are saying whatever is written here in green, this one, okay, whatever is written here in green, this is the knowledge of real estate industry, is given just for knowledge purpose, not for examination purpose. But without having this background knowledge of real estate sector, it is impossible to understand what this reverse charge is, and therefore you need to have combined knowledge, whether it they have given for examination purpose or not. You need to know a complete thing, what is happening in GST and what are the conditions which are there to avail the rate of 1% and 5%. Okay, friends. So this is what we have discussed 9.4. If you are having any query, then please let me know.